With the release of the Grey One Red Deer, we have figured that the best place to grind for them is on Cuatro Colinas. So today, I'm gonna show you how to set up a grind for them on this reserve. This setup is focused on killing all those males as quickly as possible. Alright, first of all, why I think Cuatro Colinas is the best option to grind for them? The answer to that is that Cuatro Colinas has the most open areas in comparison with the other reserves. Probably only the Awaroa has more, but the nighttime drink time on that map, combined with the rainy weather, it just makes it a lot hard to spot them. Perhaps the Awaroa has more big red deer, yet if it's gonna be hard to kill a lot of them, it's probably not the best option. Also, most of the dead grey ones have been on the Awaroa, and although this problem doesn't seem to be tied to any reserve, there's probably something on the Awaroa that makes it more likely to occur. Okay, anyway, we are gonna start with the best weapon to grind for them, which is the 303. Actually, both the 303 and the M1 are perfect rifles to grind for them. Of course, you can also use the 7mm, which is very good, but it doesn't provide the speed of these other two rifles. You could even use the 300, which doesn't give full integrity, but it will kill them real quick. At the end, what we want is to kill as many stacks as possible, because getting respawns is what we want, and eventually, a great one. In order to kill as many stacks as possible, of course you will want to place tents. If you can place all 16 tents, that would be perfect. Also, the tripods and tree stands, I think both are a very important piece of equipment. They will give you height, also a good cover, and the most important thing in my opinion is that they reduce the hunting pressure. As you can see here, I shot 3 stacks and the hunting pressure is minimal. I think they help a lot. Take in mind that this is expensive equipment in-game, but it is worth it and even essential, especially talking about the tents. They all cost 16,000 in-game bucks per unit, both the tents, tripods, and tree stands. They are definitely not cheap, but I think they are a game changer on this kind of grind. If you don't have enough in-game money to cover all the spots, I will show you the best locations later on this video. A very important thing is that before you place the tent and the tripod on a certain lake, you'll want to check where are the drink zones. You'll want to see their exact location. If there is a drink zone on this side of the lake, you'll want to place the tent on the opposite side. And make sure you place it at least at 250 meters from the drink zone. The tripod is safe to place it at like 150 or 160 meters. In certain spots, you won't need a tripod or a tree stand. And that's for example on certain areas where the trees are not very tall. So in that case, if you place a tripod, you would end up seeing the treetops and that doesn't help. Now talking about shot placement, both the 303 and the M1 have enough penetration to get a double long at relatively short distances like 150 meters. If you're at more than 300, you can still get a single long, even if they are facing you on a diagonal like this. You can still get a single long, aiming right there. And it will take them some time to die, but they still die fairly quick. If you count the hard shots, they will save you a lot of time. I'm gonna go for a hard here. And that was a hard shot. It was kinda far, but as you can see, they are not hard to get. Gonna go for another one right here. And that was good. A good thing is that in frontal shots like this, if you don't get the heart, usually you will hit a single long, so it is a very safe shot. Now I'm gonna go over the hotspots, also my setup. Okay, so here's the map, and as you can see, I have placed a tent and a tripod on every leg with them. The idea is to fast travel to a tent and then get on the tripod as quickly as possible to kill all the males on the opposite side. Then I go around the lake to pick them up and then I check the side of the lake where I have my tent to see if there's any drink zone right there, because it's common that new drink zones might appear close to your tent, so you won't be able to see them unless you're on the other side. Let me show you what I mean. Here we have this lake where I have 2 red deer drink zones. I place a tent on the opposite side where I'm able to hunt both, but another drink zone just appeared right next to my tent. It is actually behind that mouflon drink zone. It used to be here on the right, but now it's here. So what I do is that I get on the tripod to shoot whatever is on the other side, and then I go pick them up, and once I'm there, now I can see the animals that are on the zone close to my tent. This is very simple, but in my opinion is one of the most common issues that you will find with a setup like this. So in most cases, you won't need to change your tent position. The only case where you'll need to adjust it is when all the zones are now on your side of the lake, where you have the tent. This is something that could happen eventually, especially when the zones that used to be on the other side of the lake only had like 1 or 2 bugs. It is very likely that they change their position at some point, and they could spawn very close to your tent, so you'll have to move it unless there's another zone remaining on the other side, which will give you a reason to go there to harvest a stack or something, and from there you could hunt wherever is close to your tent. Now I'm gonna continue with the best locations. Basically, these are the spots with a higher concentration of males. The first one is this giant lake. You'll find stacks all around the lake, and here I got a tripod. In this case, I don't need a tent because there's an outpost, and then I have another tent up here with another tripod. Take in mind that the lakes will be the same for every map, or at least the vast majority of them, but the drink zones, I mean the specific position of the drink zones, will be different on each map. So this exact tent positioning is probably not gonna be the best option for you, mainly because a lot of your drink zones will be on a different position than mine, so you'll have to figure out the best position for your tents once you discover all your drink zones. Another excellent lake is this one up here. I have gotten 2 diamonds there. It's a very good spot. Also, all the lakes around this hill are very good. Definitely you would want to place tents there. Pretty much all these lakes are decent, but at least in my map, this lake right here also seems to be very good. Actually, I think 2 alive great ones have been killed on that lake, so definitely go in there. Also, this lake is very good, and this corner right here, it has something. That's where I got my melanistic diamond wild boar. Also, I know another player that got a diamond piebald already right there, and another one that got an albino diamond, so it has something. Then, these 2 lakes down here are very good, usually. Well, on my map, honestly, they are not great. I find maybe 2 or 3 stacks on each one, but I've seen multiplayer servers where those lakes are loaded. Like, seriously loaded. So, in your map, they might be better. I also made this map with pretty much all the spots. The yellow ones are the best ones, and the red ones are the ones that are okay. They are not necessarily bad, but they are not the best. A very important tip, either if you want to get a grey one or a diamond, is that you don't need to hunt every single spot to spawn one. You can stick to spots that work the best for you. I mean, you can choose a few, and that's where you do all the grind. If you want to do this, I would recommend you to choose the spots where you can kill the most males. Then you can check the other ones only sometimes, just to make sure there's nothing there. Another tip that I think is very useful is that let's say you see a herd at more than 300 meters, and maybe it has 3 or 4 males, you will want to kill them all, so to do that, or to attempt to do that, most people will zoom into the max, especially when using the Argus scope. Well, what I recommend you is, instead of zoom in, you should zoom out. Zoom out to a max. This way, you will barely feel the recoil, and even less when combined with this perk, Recoil Management, located on the shotgun section. Make sure to buy it. Another tip, well, this is not really a tip, this is something basic. After you finish a run and you want to get your response, the only thing you need to do is to go to a main menu. Then you can return and you will see the response. You don't need to reset the time, you don't need to completely close the game, just go to a main menu. Now the last thing is that in order to get response, you don't need to harvest the animals. So maybe you're short of time and you still want to get some response, well, you can leave the bodies there and they will respawn as normal. Honestly, I don't recommend you to abuse of this, because if you abuse, it could become an exploit. But I feel you need to know this, since a lot of times we don't have enough time to grind, so this is a way to save some. Alright, I really hope this video helps, and we have to be patient because we never know when a great one could spawn. I hope you enjoyed this video, thanks for watching, and see you next time.